I want to now bring in two individuals who know a lot about this and come from different positions, even though they are both Democrats. I'm going to start with Congressman Keith Ellison, Democrat from Minnesota, and then in studio with me, the former ranking Democrat of the House Select Committee on Intelligence, Jane Harman. Congressman Ellison, I want to start with you. What are your concerns about the news that we have been hearing about the National Security Agency and their monitoring?
Well, my concern is that I just don't think a million people are legitimate suspects based on facts of terrorist activity, and I think it's just too broad. But I think this is an occasion for Congress to go back and try to more narrowly tailor the latitude under the Patriot Act. I think this is not really something you can blame the Obama administration for, because I think any executive branch is going to operate at the extent of the law. But I think the law is overbroad, and I think we need to have some requirement that there be some real basis for surveilling people before you look at their phone records like that.
Congresswoman Harman, is the law too broad? Does it need to be narrowed? Or, knowing what you know, having served as a ranking Democrat on the House Select Committee on Intelligence, does law enforcement and National Security Agency, do they need to be able to look at all of this data?
Well, first of all, let me say how closely Keith and I have worked together over the years and how much I admire him and his particular courage and perspectives. On this subject, Congress has been careful. There were abuses after 9/11. The Bush administration, early from 2002 to 2005, was conducting a program to use phone records, but it was outside the law, the Foreign Intelligence Surveillance Act. When Congress figured this out, and I was one of the people who did, We expressed enormous concern, and FISA, the law, was revised in 2007 with the support of then-Senator Obama and many of us. And that revision has been reviewed and extended numerous times, and the section we're talking about has been reviewed and extended.
This seems very broad, Congresswoman.
Well,
it seems very broad. Millions of Americans, their data being looked at without
any... Their data is not being looked at. Their data is in a database which can only be looked at if they're Americans, if there is an individualized court order to look at the data. And in the case of phone records, people's calls aren't being recorded. Prospectively, if there's an individual court order, just like in a criminal case, as President Obama explained today, then you can listen to somebody's conversation. But the only reason you would get there is if some foreign connection leads you there. This is a database to help us find whoever the older Tsarnaev might have been talking to in Dagestan. That's the point, and to learn about his plans to harm us before he does that. And it's not going to be used for any other reason. And the other program that's been in the news, too, the email program, doesn't apply to Americans at all, as President Obama explained.
Congressman Ellison?
Well, you know, the thing is that I believe that Congress comes back together to review the state of the law all the time. This is an occasion where we should do that. We should come back together and say, look, do we really need to be spreading the net quite this wide? It is rather wide. It is disturbing to a lot of people. And quite frankly, I worry about not just invasions of privacy, but how many leads are we following where there's just really nothing there? The fact is, Temerlin Tsarnaev was sort of known to be a problem. There were facts that would lead law enforcement to Temerlin Tsarnaev. But how many people, are caught up in this thing who really aren't in that category at all?
Go ahead.
I think the program, I think we should review it, too. I agree with you, Keith. And I also think we should review other laws and consider stricter laws around the use of drones, for example. And I'm pleased to see Senators McCain and Feinstein in Guantanamo Bay today talking about whether it can be closed. I surely hope it can be closed.
That's right.
But in this case, what I'm saying is that the FISA court, which is federal judges who rotate in and out of there and are highly trained, reviews this all the time. And in addition to that, Congress is fully briefed. The intelligence committees are fully briefed, as they said yesterday. And we are being careful. Should it be looked at? Sure. Congress has a right to do careful oversight and should do oversight. And as you said at the beginning, or as President Obama said, there's no such thing as 100% security or 100% liberty. But I think we either get more of both or less of both. It's not a zero-sum game.
Congressman Ellison, are you comfortable with what Congresswoman Harman said about, look, this data isn't looked at, it's just accumulated, and then if the law enforcement, the national security apparatus needs needs to go back and look at it, then it's looked at. Is that, does that sit well with you? Are you okay with that?
Well, we hope it isn't. I mean, the reality is if it's there, you know, there's at least the potentiality that somebody is going to look into it. Now, you might say, well, they don't have the authority to do so. But that, if we look at history as a guide, if information is available to be looked into, often it will be. So I think this is the time and the occasion to say we're casting the net too widely. Now, I'll say this about President Obama's statement, no 100% privacy, no 100% security. Obviously, that's right. But that's why we have to constantly strike the balance. It's a cop-out to say 100%, 100% this, 100% that. No American thinks that we're going to have 100% privacy or 100% security. But we've got to strike the balance better than we have been. And I think it is Congress's duty. You know, my comments are not, I'm not throwing a bunch of vitriol at Obama. I think the executive, Bush, Obama, Clinton, they're going to go to the extent of what the law allows. Congress needs to drill down. And I'll just tell you this. Jane's absolutely right. Some members of Congress know about this, but a lot don't. I mean, if you're not on the Intelligence Committee, you may not be in the loop at all. I'm not.
All right, we'll just have to leave it there. We're going to have both of you back to talk about this at a later date. Thank you so much. Have a good weekend to both of you.